Assalamualaikum and hello everyone. So today, we're going to explain about Latin America and the country inside them. So, there are 33 countries inside Latin America. Here is the map of Latin America. The first three countries that I'm going to explain is Panama, Costa Rica and Nicaragua. But before I explain more detail about these three countries, first, I'm going to tell you about the similarities of this country. The first similarities that I'm going to explain is climate change. These three countries has a humid tropical climate with distinct dry and rainy season. Moreover, rainy season normally starts from May to November and the dry season will start at December and end at April. Furthermore, another similarity is the environmental problem, which is deforestation. Deforestation gives a lot of impact to the soil and plants, which deforestation causes soil erosion, especially during the rainy day. Next, we move to another similarity, which is organization. Those countries is under presidential system, which the president is both head of the state and head of the government. That's all the similarities between those three countries. The first country that I'm going to explain is Panama. Panama is a country of Central America located on the isthmus of Panama, which the narrow bridge land that connect the north and the south of America. It is a home for several Native American people such as Kwame, Kuna and Koko. Moving on to the next point, which is the history of Panama. Before Panama declared their independence, US tried to convince Panama to break away from Colombia. In order to do so, US will give military support to Panama. At 3rd November 1903, Panama has declared independence with protections of US. The reason why US willing to give military support to Panama is because Colombia reject US to build transcontinental canal through Panama. Next, I'm going to tell you about the Panama's culture. The Panama's culture is a blend of Africa, America, Indian, North America and Spanish influence from the perspective of arts, music and others. The lifestyle of people in the cosmopolitan and rural area are very different, which the cosmopolitan people are tends to be more advanced while the people in the rural area are tends to be more traditional and the poor will become poor. Finally, is the current issues in Panama, which is the COVID-19 has impacted the economies in Panama. Panama had more cases of coronavirus than other countries in Central America. According to the Atlantic Council News, said that the country still unable to improve its international reputation for transparency. The second country that I'm going to explain is Costa Rica. Costa Rica is located in between of Nicaragua and Panama, which in north, they have Nicaragua and in the south, they have Panama. They have lots amount of animal and plant. Moving on to the next point, which is history of Costa Rica. Costa Rica remained a Spanish colony for almost 300 years. In 1821, Costa Rica and other Central America colonies declared independence from Spain. In 1838, it became an independent country. The next point is culture in Costa Rica. The culture itself is very unique. They are very friendly. Even when they meet foreigners, they will try to speak in English. The traditional clothes that they wear is for women. They wore colorful, long and wavy skirt and shoulderless blouse. For men, they wore pants with white shirt and a kerchief around the neck and also a white brim hat that called chinet and a big and colorful belt. Next is the current issue in Costa Rica. According to the Tico Time in October 21, 2020, they said that due to heavy rain, CNU recommend people have to take appropriate precautions in particular area due to flooding, while people that live near the river need to stay alert in case the landslide happen. The last country is Nicaragua. Nicaragua is the largest country in Central America. They also can be characterized by its agriculture economy. Nicaragua is made up mostly of mestizos, which is people of mixed Euro and Indian ancestry. Next is the history of Nicaragua. They gained their independence from Spain in 1821. However, the independence did not go well because Granada and Leon City keep on fight with each other. Moreover, the internal conflict continued until April 30, 1838 and then Nicaragua declared full independence. Next, about the Nicaragua cultures. Is in Nicaragua, people tend to speak different languages such as English and Spanish. The religion here are mostly Christian. Moreover, there are many fiestas such as Semana Santa, San Sebastian and others. The fiesta in here are a time of joy and fun. Lastly is the current issues, which is political issues. These issues rises because of the president, who is Daniel Ortega, is making life increasingly hard for aid and human rights group in Nicaragua. He is criticized for a dismissive and reckless response to the coronavirus outbreak. This is according to the New Humanitarian News on September 2, 2020. Lastly, is the two sub-regions that I will present is Central America and Mexico. First, the major economic activities of Central America including agriculture powerhouse and tourism industry, while the major economic activities in Mexico are oil production, mineral exploitation, manufacturing such as coffee, sugar and corn. Lastly, is high-tech industry. Now, I'm going to pass the time to the next presenter, Shakira.
Hola a todos, mi nombre es Nur Shakira y espero que lo estén haciendo muy bien hoy. Hi everyone, my name is Nur Shakira and I hope you are doing very well today. I am introducing myself in Spanish because that is the official language of the countries in Latin America. So, the three countries that I'm going to present to you are Uruguay, Paraguay and Argentina. These three regions are located in the Southern America, in the region of Latin America. So let's start! Before I start, I will share with you about the similarities between these three countries. Uruguay, Paraguay and Argentina has a humid subtropical climate, which means the zone of climate characterized by hot and humid summers and cool to mild winters. All of these three countries also have similarity in their traditional clothing, which are gauchos, colorful ponchos, big brim straw hats, boldly patterned scarves and traditional berets. A long colorful skirt paired with an off-shoulder blouse is customary for women. First off, Uruguay. The current president of Uruguay is Luis Lacapu. The estimated population in the country are about 3 million people. The capital city of Uruguay is Montevideo, and the currency that they are using is in peso uruguayo. Furthermore, they are also facing some environmental issues, which is also the current issues in the country, which is water pollution from its meatpacking and tanner industry. This problem affects and hurts the fishing industry, which is one of the most lucrative industry in the country. Next, I will share a little bit about the history of Uruguay. The name Uruguay comes from the language Guarani and has a few different translations, such as river where the bird lives, river of the painted birds, river of the snails, and winding river. Uruguay became independent of Spain in 1811 and was annexed by Brazil until 1825. Following a three-year federation with Argentina, Uruguay became an independent nation in 1828. Finally, about the organizations in Uruguay. Uruguay is a representative democratic republic with a presidential system. The members of the government are elected for a 5-year term by a universal suffrage system. Next country is Paraguay. The current president of Paraguay is Mario Abdo Benitez. The estimated population in the country are about 7 million people. The capital city of Paraguay is Asuncion, and the currency that they are using is in Paraguayan Guarani. There are many environmental issues in Paraguay, but I will highlight about one of the issues, which is pollution. Many of the country's rivers suffer from toxic dumping, which is caused by tanner industries. Next, I will tell you a little bit about the history of Paraguay. What we know is that the name of Paraguay derives straight from the Paraguay River. This body of water is the lifeblood of the country, which flows for more than 1,600 miles through Brazil, Bolivia, Paraguay, and flows into the Paraná River at the border with Argentina. Paraguay is founded by Juan de Salazar D. Espinosa through colonization. The first Europeans in the area were Spanish explorers in 1516. Paraguay then declared its independence from Spain on 15 May 1811. Next, about the current issues in Paraguay. Paraguay acted forcefully against COVID-19 and succeeded in containing the pandemic with very few cases and casualties. But the economic impact has been harsh, so the GDP is forecast to shrink 5% this year. Furthermore, the affairs of Paraguay take place within the context of the Presidential Representative Democratic Republic. The National Constitution provides for the separation of powers in three branches. The Economic Intelligence Unit rated Paraguay as a failed democracy in 2019. Now, let's move on to the next country, which is Argentina. The current president of Argentina is Alberto Fernandez. The estimated population in the country are about 45 million people. The capital city of Argentina is Buenos Aires, and the currency that they are using is in Argentine peso. Next, the biggest environmental issues in Argentina are deforestation and the depletion of fertile property. The soil is endangered by erosion, salinization, and deforestation. Air contamination is also an issue caused by chemical agents from manufacturing sources. Next, about the history of Argentina, the name Argentina comes from the Latin Argentinum, which is silver. The earliest use of name Argentina can be traced back to the travels of the Spanish conquerors to the Rio de la Plata. On 9 July 1816, they declared the country independent under the name of the United Provinces of the Rio de la Plata. Next, about the current issue in Argentina. According to AlJazeera.com, Argentina was facing a third year of recession in 2020, even before the coronavirus hit. Now, with the pandemic's economic shock, some analysts foresee a record contraction in the crisis-prone country. Furthermore, the politics of Argentina take place within the context of what the constitution describes as a federal constitutional parliamentary democratic republic, where the president of Argentina is both head of the state and head of the government. Next, for the sub-region, the two sub-regions that I will present to you are Southern America and North Andes. First, the major economic activities of the Southern America are including agriculture, industry, forestry, and mining. While the major economic activities of the North Andes are agricultural, mineral resources, and hydroelectricity. That's all from me. Thank you for listening, and I will pass to my friend. Thank you. Bye bye.
Hola a todos. Mi nombre es Nabila Natasha. Y espero que esté bien.
Hello everyone. My name is Nabila Natasha, and I hope you are doing fine. A three country that I'm going to present, which is Cuba, Haiti, and Dominican Republic. These three countries are located in the Caribbean, which is the region of Latin America. Cuba is the country with the population 11.34 million people, and their president right now is the Miguel Díaz-Canel. They are using Cuban peso as their currency. The capital city is Havana. Met in Cuba. Cuba has a Caribbean subtropical climate with hot, rainy, and humid summer weather and mild winter weather. One of the environmental problems in Cuba is soil degradation, which affects the fertile land has led to increase of pollution and sedimentation in stream and river. Next, we are moving to their history and culture. On 1492, Christopher Columbus landed in Cuba and claimed the land for Spain and named the land as Isla Juana. But later, it will be called Cuba, which comes from the local Native American name Cubana. That means Great Peace. Cuba gained their independence on 1902. As for their culture, Cuba has rich culture which are mainly an amalgamation of influence from Africa and Spain. The most influential elements are its music and art by far. Cuba has had a democratic centralist political system embodied in one state, one party since 1959. Genetically, Cuba is a socialist country ruled by the decades of Marxism. The current issue that Cuba is facing right now is on September 2020, United States President Donald Trump announced new sanctions on Cuba, restricting of Cuban rum and cigars, and banning Americans from staying at properties owned by Cuban government. And next, we are moving to Haiti. Haiti is the country with the population 11.12 million people, and their president is Jovenel Moïse. They are using Haitian gourd as their currency, and their capital city is Port-au-Prince. We are moving to their climate. Haiti has a warm, humid tropical climate characterized by diurnal temperature variations that are greater than annual variation. As for their environmental issue, it is also their current issue. Major challenges in Haiti is a waste management in Haiti, which is urban area, especially in Port-au-Prince, which is their capital city.
Widespread deforestation is a critical concern in Haiti and poses a serious threat to the life of Haitian citizens. As for their history and culture, the name of Haiti is derived from the indigenous Taino Arawak name for the entire island is Hispaniola, which they call Haiti. That's mean Haiti gained their independence on 1804 and become the second independent nation in the American. Personal greeting are very important in Haiti. This is part of their culture, where men are usually shake their hand, while girls throw a kiss on cheeks. Government of Haiti is a semi-presidential republic system, where the president serves as head of state and prime minister serves as a head of government. The last country that I'm going to present is Dominican Republic. There are 10.63 million people in the country and they are using Dominican peso as their currency. As for their capital city is Santo Domingo and their current president right now is Luis Abinader. The climate in Dominican Republic is generally hot with tropical temperature all year, although it does vary from region to region. The environmental problem that the Dominican Republic face is in the areas of deforestation, water supply and soil erosion. And as the eroding soil enter the sea, and from that it damaged the nation's coral reef as well. As for their history and culture, Dominican Republic is named after a saint. Before their independence, the country was called as Santo Domingo, which is after Saint Dominic. The Dominican Republic gained their independence on February 17, 1844. People started to call their country La República Dominicana, which means the Dominican Republic. The Dominican Republic form of organization. The Dominican Republic is a representative democracy with three arms of power, which is the executive, legislature, and judiciary. It is also a multi-party state with the presidential election. The Dominican current issue is their environmental problem, where every year nearly 20,000 hectares of land are being destroyed due to the commercial building. There are two sub-regions that I'm going to present, which is the Caribbean and the Brazil. Major activity in Brazil is mining, agriculture, and manufacturing. While for the Caribbean, the major economic activity is agriculture. That's all from us. Thank you. Gracias.